just do heating effect of current. What we are doing here? Heating effect of current. What practically we have observed when we connect any conducting wire or conductor across an EMF source, say potential difference V, current begins to flow through a conductor AB, and if I keep this wire AB connected with an EMF source, then after some time you will find the wire started getting heated. Now you have and we have practically made a flow of current through the wire, but wire is getting heated after a certain time. This shows a part of electrical energy gets converted into heat energy, right? This is called heating effect. What is heating effect? When a current is continuously flowing through a wire for a long time, the wire gets heated up, and thus the phenomenon of heating of wire, you can write it here, the phenomenon of heating of wire or conductor due to continuous flow of current through a conductor is called heating effect of current. Now, big question is that why wire gets heated up, right? So what actually happens when we apply potential difference? As we know, electric field is set up inside the conductor, and this electric field moves free electrons inside the conductor from negative to positive side. And as we have seen, even in motion of electron, that is called drift velocity, these electrons cannot have uniform motion. These electrons also cannot be accelerated, but what continuously accelerated, but what actually happens, every time electron get accelerated, and as soon as it travels, it collides with a neighbor molecule and it loses kinetic energy. So in every collision with the neighbor molecule, when electrons are colliding, they lose their kinetic energy, and this amount of loss of kinetic energy by the electron actually appears in form of heat energy. So let's consider, let Q charge, Q is the charge, passed through a conductor when potential difference V is applied across it. So work done by definition is Q into V, but Q is, you can write it as I into T, so VIT is another formula, or we can use Ohm's law. So using Ohm's law, I hope you remember Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, put the value of B there, then what you will get? I square R into T. This is one of the formula for work done. Now from Joule's law, work done is directly, or amount of heat energy is produced is directly proportional to work done. So work done is directly proportional to H. Work done is directly proportional to H. So work done is how much? This. So you can say amount of heat energy is directly proportional to I square RT. This is what is called Joule's law of heating. And according to Joule's law of heating, the amount of heat energy produced H is directly proportional to I square, that is current, directly proportional to the resistance, directly proportional to the time duration for which current is being allowed to pass through a conductor. Right? That's what is called Joule's law heating. Other forms of this also you can manipulate from equation 2. See here. Work done can also be written as, if we put use this law again and put I is equal to V over R, so we will have V square R into T. Another form. Right? So we can have 3-4 forms. Work done is equal to QV, work done is equal to VIT, work done is equal to IR, I square RT, work done is equal to V square over R. Right? Let's take one simple example. Through a conductor, five ampere current flows for 5 seconds. Calculate the amount of heat energy produced if the resistance of the conductor is 2 ohm. Simple question. So use formula H is equal to I square RT. Rather, you can say this is a straight question which you can attempt on it. I is 5 ampere, so 5 square, resistance is 2, time is 5, so 125 into 2, 250 joules of heat energy produced. Another term which is very frequently used is electric power. How do we define electric power? It is defined as rate of doing work. So electric power is equal to work done over time. SI unit you can say 1 joule over 1 second. That is equal to 1 watt. That we have already defined, but you can still define it again. Power of an electrical device is said to be 1 watt when it consumes 1 joule of energy in 1 second. Now, if we assume if we assume Q amount of charge is moved by a potential difference V, then work done is much QV, therefore electric power is W over T QV, sorry, so QV over T. Q over T by definition is current, so V into I, one expression. You can define 1 watt of power from here also. 1 watt is equal to 1 volt into 1 ampere, right? So when 1 volt of potential difference circulates 1 ampere current through a circuit, the power consumed by a device is said to be 1 watt. Now use Ohm's law again, using V is equal to IR. So another expression of power will be, if we replace the value of V, then I square R. And now if I replace the value of I, then it is P is equal to V square over R. So two more forms of this. Larger unit of electric power, as we know, is kilowatt, and then 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. More bigger unit is megawatt, 10 raised to the power 6. Commercial unit is horsepower, that is 746 watt. Normally we use power of electrical devices in terms of HPs, horsepowers. Now, if I want to know that how much energy we are consuming with certain rate of the power consumption, then we need to calculate energy consumed by the devices, by a device or devices. How do you, work done is energy, so work done is equal to power into time, and power unit, if it is 1 kilowatt, time if I take 1 kilowatt hour, this comes out unit of energy consumed, that is kilowatt hour. And commercially it is termed as one unit. And you or we or everybody in the society pays electricity bill on the basis of number of units. So government and electrical corporations charges electrical consumption bill from the household by using this unit, one unit. So one unit is equal to how many joules? Just have a look. 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt, and 1 hour is 60 minutes, then 60 second. So this comes out 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 5 joules. It means you are consuming huge amount of energy and government is charging still less, say 2 rupees per unit, for example. So this much energy you are consuming and charges are, you can say, just 2 rupees. So don't have grievances so much. If you are consuming, then one has to pay. That's what is the rest. Let's have one question related with calculation of electricity bill. In a house, 5 bulbs of 65 watts. In a house, 5 bulbs each of 60 watt is used 5 hours daily. A refrigerator, a fridge of say 400 watt is used 24 hours in a day, and an electric motor of 2 kilowatt of 2 kilowatt is run 2 hours a day. Calculate electricity bill at the rate of 2 rupees per unit. So first see how many kilowatt hours you have used. Solution: due to bulbs, kilowatt hours five bulbs each of 60 watt divided by 1000 to convert into kilowatt into 5, how much it is? kWh, right? And then due to fridge, 400 divided by 1000 into 24 hours, then how much your two zeros get cancelled? That is 9.6 kWh. An electric motor is 2 kilowatt into how many hours? 2 hours. So 4 kWh. Calculate total consumption. 1.5 and 9.6. This is 11.1, 15.1 kWh. And then unit price is cost of bill. One day cost will be 15.1 units into 2 into that will be 30.2 rupees. Therefore monthly bill rupees 30.2 into 30, how much will it be? 906 rupees per month.